flashlight is one feature that came from Half-Life to Counter-Strike 1.6. Lots of maps in this version have dark spots, making the flashlight a useful tool for spotting enemies. It has a power supply that lasts for 2 minutes, after which it shuts off. With the release of Counter-Strike Source, the flashlight remained, but compared to the previous version, its range became limited, and the power source became infinite. In CSGO, the ability to use the flashlight was disabled. Over time, the official maps became brighter, making extra lighting unnecessary. But you can still turn it on using this console command. Since CS2 is basically an update to CSGO, there's no flashlight here either. I couldn't find any console commands to turn it on, so just press F to pay for skins. Night vision goggles are another cool feature that used to make me feel like some kind of secret agent and gave me a unique gaming experience. By the way, if you didn't know, in CS 1.6 you can adjust the brightness of the goggles using these console commands on your screen. In CSS, night vision is also available, but it doesn't have the same strong effect as in the previous version of the game. You also can't adjust brightness. Just like the flashlight, you can't buy night vision goggles in CSGO. But they're still in the game files, and you can get them with a few console commands. And in CS2, even cheats won't help you. The ability to get night vision goggles disappeared when moving from CSGO. In CS 1.6, you can choose from one of 4 character classes. The same option is available in Source. But what about CS2?
Here comes the money!
Here we go!
Money talk!
So, what we have come to? Players aren't just picking characters anymore. We are buying agents, stickers, weapon skins and knives. And then what? Skins for C4, grenades, boots? Well, if that's the case, then it's best to get skins on SKINCLUB, one of the most popular platforms for opening CS2 cases. Battle against other players for skins, join solo or team battles, or create your own. And in crazy mode, the player who unboxes the lowest total value of skins wins the battle. By completing simple missions, you'll get sweet prizes. And what about free daily cases? Of course, they're available here. The higher your profile level, the more expensive cases you will open. For example, the cheapest skin in the last level case costs 100 bucks. Don't forget to join the family loyalty event. Play on SKINCLUB and earn even points which can be spent on various rewards in the marketplace. And you can get a 7% deposit bonus by clicking on my link in the description and enjoy your SKINCLUB experience.
Get me out of here.
As the Counter-Strike series has evolved, the hostage mechanics have changed a lot. In CS 1.6, you could kill the hostages, but you would get a money penalty for it. To rescue them, you had to politely ask them to follow you, and they would. To win the round, you had to bring all the hostages to the city spawn point, or at least half of them if any were dead. Here's a funny fact. If you bring half of the hostages to the city spawn, then go back and kill the remaining two, you would still win the round. This works in a somewhat strange way, doesn't it? In CSS, hostages also died from gunfire, and they would still follow you. However, to win the round, you only needed to bring at least one living hostage to the rescue zone. In the early version of CSGO, the hostage mechanics were the same as in the previous series. However, in March 2013, the rules changed significantly. Since then, and in Counter-Strike 2, there are only 2 hostages on the map, they are immortal, they don't follow you anymore, and you could carry only one hostage at a time on your back to the rescue zone. When you pick up a hostage, you get an extra minute added to the round timer. To win the round, you just need to rescue one hostage. The tactical shield is one of the main gear items in CS 1.6. It's only available to the counter-terrorist team, replaces the primary weapon, and is used alongside pistols, knives and grenades. In CSS, the shield was removed from the game, but was reintroduced in one of the CSGO updates. Initially, it became available in Danger Zone as the Ballistic Shield, and later in casual mode on hostage rescue maps as the Riot Shield, but with some changes. The shield is no longer used with pistols. You can carry it in your inventory with all weapons, and it hangs on your back. When using the shield, players can only perform bash attacks on other players, which deal damage and disarm them. The shield can be completely destroyed if it takes enough damage. At the time of making this video, CS2 doesn't have a shield or the danger zone mode. However, many models from this mode can be found in the game's files. The ammo system in CS 1.6 is a part of the game's economy. When you buy a weapon, you don't receive a full load of ammo, but you can purchase more if needed. At the beginning of a new round, your ammo remains the same as it was at the end of the previous round. There's more. If you buy a primary and secondary weapon that use the same caliber, the ammo will be combined into one pool. So if you get MP5 along with your Glock and use up all the ammo on one, don't be surprised if there's none left for the other. In CSS, you get a full ammo when you buy a new weapon and at the start of each round for your received weapons. But if you run out of ammo completely, you can go back to the buy zone and get more. In an early version of CSGO, there was also a shared ammo pool, and you just had to go back to the buy zone where ammo would be automatically refilled. In the latest version of CSGO and in CS2, each weapon has its own ammo pool, which only refills at the start of each round or when you buy a new weapon. Sprays are another unique thing for Counter-Strike. In 1.6, you have a variety of sprays to choose from, and you can even give them different colors. I've seen many guides on how to install a custom spray, but many players say they only work offline. However, in CSS, you can add any custom spray that will be visible to other players online. And yeah, you know what went down in CS2.
Here comes the money!
Here we go! Money talks!
Sprays were renamed to graffiti. You should pay for them. You can use them a limited number of times, and you also can't add custom sprays. GG. The buy menu in CS 1.6 is as simple as it can be. Besides hotkeys for buying weapons, you can auto-buy or get the same gear as the last round. One thing I've always loved since 1.6 is the option to switch to the old style menu, which doesn't take up the whole screen. In Counter-Strike Source, the buy menu is very similar to 1.6, but here you can't use the old style menu. Instead, in the lower right corner, you have the option to set your presets for quick buying equipment for each team. With the release of CSGO, we got the buy wheel, allowing you to admire your cool character with skins and quickly drop the purchased weapon to your teammates.
Bullshit!
To set up quick buys, you should write console commands in the config. In CS2, the buy menu turned into a table with limited weapons, so you pick your starting weapons in the loadout menu. What's really great is that you can quickly pick up a dropped weapon in the buy zone, and you can also refund your weapon if you bought the wrong one. Actually, the biggest loss in Counter-Strike for me is Double Duck. Oh, wait a minute, I can still play CS 1.6 compared to CSGO.